Good morning, students. Welcome for the second part of the question answers of the chapter 10, History, Displacing Indigenous Peoples. So we have discussed the NCERT questions and the very first question, very short question answers in the first video. Let's start the short, long, and the map work in this video. So question number one from the short answer type questions. What do you understand by imperialism? Name a few countries who encouraged imperialism. When a country establishes its economic and political control over any country, it is known as imperialism. The imperial country tries to maintain its strict control over the resources of colonial countries. The countries which encouraged a policy of imperialism were the following: Great Britain, Spain, France, Holland, and Portuguese. Question two. Discuss the physiographic features of the continent of North America. Physiographic feature of the continent of North America. This continent extends from Arctic Circle to the Tropic of Cancer, from the Pacific to the Atlantic Ocean. The Rocky Mountain chain is the east of the Great Plains, the Great Lakes, the Valley of the Mississippi, and the Ohio and the Malachine Mountains. The Great Lake, the Valley of Mississippi, and Ohio, and the Great Plains lies towards the east of the continent. Mexico is situated towards its south. Question three. What do you know about the earliest inhabitants of North America? It is established that the earliest inhabitants of North America came from Asia on a land bridge across the Bering Strait about 30,000 years ago. They moved towards the south during the Ice Age 10,000 years ago. The oldest artifacts was found in America about 11,000 years ago. About 5,000 years ago, due to climatical stability, population began to increase. Before the advent of Europeans, the Native Americans used to live along the river valley and produce crops such as maize and several kinds of vegetables. Question four. How did the exchange of goods between the European traders and the native of North America prove beneficial for the Europeans? Answer. After arriving North America, the European traders came to know that the native peoples assembled regularly at the bank of the river Mississippi with an objective of exchange of goods. They exchanged handicrafts and food items. Only those goods were exchanged which were not available in a particular region. The European traders took part in the exchange of food items with an objective to boost their trade. They gave items like blankets, vessels, and gun. These items proved beneficial for the natives in one or another way. Before the advent of the Europeans, the natives were not familiar with the wine, but the Europeans made them addicted with of wine. It proved very beneficial for the Europeans and succeeded in dictating their terms of natives. Question five. What were the views of natives regarding trades and Europeans? Natives' views regarding trade. They had different views as compared to Europeans. The natives consider exchange of gifts between friends as a social behavior, but for the Europeans, it was just for profit making. The European traders wanted to earn more money by selling items such as fish and fur. The natives were unable to understand why the European traders sometimes offer so much in lieu of exchange of goods, and at other time they offer so little for same. Did they not know anything about trade views about the Europeans? They remained unaware about the Europeans for quite a long time. In their folk tales, they portrayed the white people, that is European traders, as greedy and foolish people. Question six. Discuss the views of Washington Irving regarding the natives. Washington Irving was a famous American writer who personally got a chance to meet North American natives. According to him, they lived with the white people and spoke less because they were unaware about their language. When they gathered together, they did not miss even a single chance to entertain themselves by mocking at the Europeans. The Europeans, on the other hand, believed that the natives respected them because they impressed the natives with their magnificence and glory. But it was a fact that the Europeans did not treat the natives with respect. Question 7. Why did the Europeans start to come and settle down in America during 19th century? Write any three reasons behind it. The Europeans started to come and settle down in America during 19th century. The possible reasons behind it were the following. In France and Britain, the younger sons had no right to inherit their father's property. Therefore, they were eager to buy their own property and took interest in to settle down in America. The farmers of Germany and Italy and Sweden had lost their land to big landlords. Now they wanted to own some land and migrated to the USA in search of pasture land. The people of Poland also started migrating to America because here land was available at comparatively less rates. The Polish people were quite happy to work in Paris grasslands because it reminded them about the steppes to their hometown. It encouraged them to buy more land here. Question 8. How will you justify that the Europeans and the natives of America had different perspectives regarding forest and agriculture? Both the Europeans and the natives of America had different perspectives regarding forest and agriculture. The Europeans cleared the forest with iron tools to make it ready for agriculture. Doing so, they wanted to increase the area under maize and other crops. The natives were surprised at their activities. They never used to grow crops as much as required for subsistence. They never thought about growing crops to make profit. They believed that forests are also their resource of strength and consider it a sin to cut them. In this way, they had different perspectives regarding forest and agriculture. Question 9. Discuss the methods adopted by the Europeans to displace the natives. Explain the expansion of European settlement in America. Natives were displaced from the region concerned. The methods adopted by the Europeans to displace the natives were the following. They used to inspire the native people to abandon those regions. In case the native refused to abandon those regions, they were threatened. They would deceitfully acquire more land from the natives and force them out from their land. Question 10. How did the Europeans justify the displacements of the natives? The Europeans justified the displacements of the natives by saying that they did not know the judicious use of their land. They criticized them by calling them sluggards. They were unaware about their craft skills to produce goods from the market. Natives were also criticized on the ground that they were not interested in learning English and wearing Western dress. So they deserved to die out. Wild beasts were killed on a large scale to clear parishes of farmland. Question 11. Write on the following. First one is the gold rush. The gold rush, it was expected that there was a gold in America. Traces of gold were found in the USA, California in the 1840s. It only led to the gold rush. A lot of Europeans went to America in the expectations of making a quick fortune. It also led to the building of railway lines throughout the continent. Thousands of Chinese workers were also recruited. Second, positions of the native Australia. Positions of the native Australia in the late 18th century, there were about 350 to 750 native communities. Each community had its own language. Most of the communities resisted in the north, that is called Torres Strait Islanders. Hence, the word अब ओरिजिन्स इज नॉट यूज्ड टू डिस्क्राइब देम एज दे माइग्रेटेड फ्रॉम डिफरेंट प्लेसेस एंड बिलोंग टू डिफरेंट रेस. दैट क्वेश्चन 12. Why did the relations between the Europeans and the native Australians became strained? Answer. Captain Cook, a British sailor, discovered Australia in 1770. Initially, the relations between the Europeans and native Australians were cordial, but with the assassination of James Hook by a native, the relations between the Europeans and the native Australians strained. They adopted a hostile attitude towards them. Question 13. Discuss the contribution of WHO's trainer in understanding the culture of the natives. The European made no sincere efforts to understand the Australian natives and their culture. It was due to their hostile attitude towards the native. In their books, the Europeans to describe their achievements, it was projected that the natives had neither any indigenous culture nor had they any history of their own. In 1968, W.E.H. Stenner published his famous book named The Great Australian Silence. In it, he encouraged the Europeans to trace and understand the historical roots of the natives of Australia. It was indeed a commendable step. Question 14. What do you understand by terris nullius? Terris nullius means belonging to nobody. The government of Australia always termed the land of Australia terra nullius. The rights of the natives were also undermined. Terra nullius were legally invalid. Discuss the beginning of the economic development of Australia with the establishment of European colonies. With the coming of Europeans and establishment of their colonies in Australia, the process of economic development steadied up. The Europeans established larger ship-rearing farms. They kept and rearing the ship merino. They cleared forests for the development of agriculture. Production of wheat were encouraged and large vineyards were established to encourage the wine industry. Mining industry was also encouraged which laid the foundation of prosperity of Australia. Long answer type questions. Discuss the features of the lifestyle of the native people of North America. The features of the lifestyle of the native people of North America were as follows. Life of the people in North America. The people lived in bands in villages along the bank of the river valley. Diet. The people used to grow crops such as maize and different types of vegetation. They also ate fish, meat, and went on hunting at far off places in search of wild buffaloes called bison. Economy. The people believed in sustenance economy. They used to grow as much crops as required to fulfill their basic needs. Land as a resource. They claimed their rights over the ownership of the land and were satisfied with the food and shelter available. There was no conflict with them for securing their rights over the ownership of land. Exchange of gifts. The natives of America used to live a life based on the principles of togetherness and mutual friendship. They did not injure themselves into sale and purchase of goods. They used to exchange gifts amongst them. Language. The native used to speak a language, number of languages, but names of these were not written down. Clothes. The natives of North America were skilled craftsmen and knew the art of weaving best quality of clothes. Question 2. How would you interpret the expansion of the USA? Also discuss the development of agriculture in the USA. Expansion of the USA. The USA and the Canada came into being towards the end of the 18th century. They occupied only a fraction of land. The imperial power of that time established 13 colonies on its eastern coast with an objective to gain her independence from Britain. In 1776, they declared a war against Britain. This war continued in 1783 and came to an half with the defeat of Britain. In this way, independence of the United States of America came into being. The USA took long time to reach the present boundaries America started expansion towards the west. To reach its present boundary, the southern region was won from Mexico. The southern expansion of America resulted in the displacement of the native time and again. By 1892, America reached its present strength. Agricultural development. The Europeans and America had purchased a large size of land holding. They cleared forest and brought more land under cultivation. They produced crops like rice and cotton. These crops were sold in European market to earn more profit. The project to protect crops from the danger of the wild predators, they hunted on large scales. The invention of barbed wire proved to be a milestone in the development of agriculture in America. What do you know about the slavery system in the USA? How was it established? Discourse. The climatical condition of a southern region was too hot. The Europeans were not able to work outward. The main intention was to employ slaves as workers. The natives of North American colonies who had been enslaved had died in great numbers. As a result, the plantation owners brought slaves in Africa. There was a wide protest by anti-slavery groups that led to a ban on slave trade. But the Africans who lived in the USA remained slaves. The economy of the North was completely different from the South. The northern states of America began to raise their voice against this practice, but the southern states were not interested in abolishing it. This led to a war between the two nations. This war continued till 4 years, that is 1861 to 1865. The northern states emerged victorious in this way, in this war. Hence, the institution of slavery was finally abolished. Abraham Lincoln and then President of America played a remarkable role in the abolition of slavery. What do you know about the wind of change in the US and Canada? Till 1920, the position of native peoples of the USA and Canada did not improve. A 1928 survey was conducted by Louis Menin, in which he narrated a grim picture of terribly poor people. The factors responsible for the wild winds of change were as follows. Indian Reorganization Act 1934. In 1934, the Indian Reorganization Act was introduced. Under the provision of this act, the natives living in reserves were given the right to obey, to buy land and take loans. Indeed, it was a landmark step in the history of natives. Declaration of Indian Rights 1954. Between 1950 to 1960, the government of America and Canada brought to establish all special provision for the natives. They hoped that the natives will support their ideas to abolish privileges, but the natives did not do it. As a result of this, in 1954, many prepared a document named Declaration of Indian Rights. In it, they said that they will accept the citizenship of America in terms that their reserves will not be taken back and there will be no interference in tradition. In 1969, the government announced that they would not recognize original rights in Canada. The native gave their support. They organized oppositions by holding debates and a series of demonstrations. By the Constitution Act of 1982, they accepted the existing aboriginal and treaty right of the natives. Write a description about the winds of change in Australia. Several factors were responsible for the winds of change in Australia. An account of the factors responsible for the winds of change are listed below. The Europeans were very hostile towards the native Australia. Since a long time, they made no sincere efforts to improve their conditions. In their literature, the Europeans portrayed themselves superior as compared to the natives. In 1968, W.E.H. Skinner published a book entitled The Great American Silence that encouraged the Europeans to trade and understand the historical roots of the natives of Australia. Henry Reynold, in his book, Why Weren't We Told, criticized the tradition of writing the Australian history. According to the Europeans, the history of Australia begins with the discovery of Captain Cook. He believed that the study of native culture and civilization must be encouraged. His ideas inspired the Europeans to know about the historical antecedents of the natives. The Europeans established separate departments in universities to study the culture of natives. To understand the local culture, they also established museums and galleries of native art. Undoubtedly, it was a commendable step. It encouraged the Australian government to adopt the policy of multiculturalism. It aimed at providing equal respect for the culture of natives. A great Australian writer, Judy Ritz, spearheaded a powerful movement for the rights of the natives. She was of the opinion that the policy of keeping the whites and the natives separate may pose a great threat to the coming generation. She wrote many impressive poems which had intense effects on the hearts of the people. The natives realized that the Europeans had made no agreement with them. It was due to this fact that the Australian government always used to call the land terra nullius, which means that land belongs to none. This verdict recognized their claims of natives over the land prior to 1770s. There was also a long and enduring history of children of mixed blood that were being forcibly captured and separated from their native lands. These children were denied all sorts of rights. Now let's start with the passage-based questions. We are having some passages. So passage one, you can see here and write down the passage. We have a question from these passages. The first three questions, read the questions and the answers are here. Second passage, who was Thomas Jefferson? He was the third president of the USA. Why was Thomas Jefferson known for? He was a renowned author. He wrote the book Declaration of Independence. What were his views about the Native Americans? He is always in favor of the Native Americans. He was of the opinion that this fortune race has suffered a lot to civilize the others. This is the third passage. We have questions from this. Three questions, we have answers here. Again, we have a passage of the Karl Marx. So who was he? What made him popular? What was his American fortune? He was a great German philosopher. He wrote a lot in favor of laborers. Okay, the theory of communists made him popular among the working class of the world. He had an opinion that the American fortune was the last positive capital utopia. Now let's start with the map skills. We have a map of Australia. You have to locate these places on the Australian map. See here, we have an Australia map. You can see all places are located. Next, we are having a USA map. You have to show the map. You have to use a USA map and you can fill with the help of the book. So these are all the question answers. Take all the question answers in your FAIR notebook and take care of your health. Thank you.